It's your girl Janette, and I just wrapped up my portion of the shoot for the project The Skin I'm In with this dude, this cat, this brother right here, Feral Self. I'm so excited, and I just want you to tell people a little bit about how this project came to be, because I thought that was pretty interesting.
Yeah, you know what? I'll be glad to tell you guys how this project came to be. Number one, thank you for coming the way from Baltimore, Maryland to be here today for this shoot. You did a phenomenal job.
Thanks.
And I am, phenomenal job, phenomenal job, man. Couldn't beat it. And your image in the project is going to be exemplary.
I'm excited to see it.
I'm excited. I took it. I'm excited to see it. But it was really unique and really different than anything else that we have in the exhibition, so I'm really excited about it. Now, you asked me, how did I actually begin to do this project? What triggered it is that, well, I think we've talked, so you know I'm a talk show host as well.
Right.
And I was in Germany last April, so exactly a year ago now, and I was interviewing the Princess of Stuttgart, Germany. And while we were at breakfast one morning, one of the waiters was an extremely dark brother, you know, and I'm saying brother, although we were in Germany.
Right.
And I said to her, I said, man, look at his melanin, isn't that cool? I was excited about it. You know, brother was super dark, you know. And she jokingly said to me, if it was midnight, we wouldn't be able to see him. And I took it as a very derogatory type of remark, and I immediately said to her, well, isn't it amazing how God created each one of us in his likeness, yet each one of us is different?
Love that.
Yeah, you know, so how can we judge each other when God created us? And you want to judge me simply based on the skin I'm in? That's not cool. And so when I got back to the States, I really began to think about it more, and I wanted to address the issue of people, you know, with different prejudices simply based on the skin we're in, which makes no sense. God created all of us, you know, in his likeness. And so I began to start this journey.
Right.
And I got on Facebook, I typed it in. I'm looking for people of various ethnicities, different skin tones, all this different stuff. And of course, I'm in Houston, Texas, so I'm looking for people in the city
locally,
of Houston.
Right.
Locally. I didn't even think all over the United States, but it was really shocking when we began to get responses from all over the world, literally all over the world, Africa, India, and all over the United States. And to date, we've had models like yourself to fly in from Baltimore. Mm-hmm. We've had Baltimore, D.C., Mississippi, Dallas, Detroit, Chicago, San Antonio, New Orleans. It's been mind-blowing to see how everybody responded to it.
I know it had to feel great to know that that your project, even though it hasn't been completed, that just the thought of it, the motivation behind it really resonated with people. Yeah. And drew them in to want to be a part of that. And you've met some really interesting people.
Yes. You know, I have been, like I was telling you a moment ago, I have been so blessed to actually make friends with some incredible people along this journey. People that I never would have met had I not been in the process of doing this project. And when I got to hear some of the stories of what they've been through, people with vitiligo, people with nevus, people that have N2, these are different things that are pertaining to the skin that make them stand out from, I guess, the average person.
Right.
And so when I hear the stories of how they're treated by society who run from them,
right,
or shun them, or call them monsters, and say these negative things about them, you know, that's a painful place to be in.
Sure.
And when I began to hear these different stories and the pain that the people have suffered, it was like one of my callings.
Right.
To showcase this and to help give the world a better understanding of people that don't look like me or you.
Right.
If that makes any sense.
No, absolutely. And I want people to come to the opening.
July the 14th, the actual opening night of this exhibition will be July 14th at the University of Houston main campus in downtown Houston. You guys don't want to miss this exhibition. Now, you can find me on Facebook. Just go to Facebook, type in Feral, that's F-E-R-R-E-L-L, Phelps, P-H-E-L-P-S. And you'll see my name right there, and you'll also see a place where you can get tickets and get more information about this particular project. It's a project that nobody should miss.
And the book, because the book will have the compilation of the stories and the background and the behind the scenes of just these people's lives.
And that's the beauty of it. With each one of the models in the project, we actually shot artistic images of everybody. And when I tell you they're beautiful shots, you guys are going to be blown away when you see some of the images in this exhibition. But the reason why we did that, we wanted to show a different side.
Sure.
We wanted to show beauty from all angles. You know, whether you're black, white, Hispanic, Indian, beauty comes in all shapes, forms, and colors. And we wanted to make sure we show that in this exhibition. And so that's what I made sure I did. And along with it, you know, the book that's coming out is called Skin Deep, The Skin I'm In. In the book, you will see the beautiful images that I've described to you, as well as the stories of what these people have experienced in their lives living in the skin they're in. And believe it or not, Janette, so many of the people that are experiencing these different skin disorders actually commit suicide.
Mm.
Yeah, and the suicide rate in the vitiligo community has been very, very high.
Yeah.
And so we want to stop this type of thing from happening. That's why it's important that we educate people about this particular skin disorder. And people will know about it, because once you're educated, you're not fearful. You're not afraid to touch a hand.
That's right.
You know what
That's
I'm saying?
Right. Yeah.
You're not afraid to communicate and interact with people. And so at this exhibition, not only will you see the images, but you'll get to meet some of these amazing, uniquely beautiful people that are part of the project, like yourself.
Oh, thank you.
So I'm so excited about it. And I just can't thank you enough for being here.
It really is my honor and my pleasure. And what we need now is your support. So we need you to tell people about it. We need you to repost this video. We need you to share the images that Farrell's releasing that support it. We need you to know that as a result of this project, he's become a person sought out to speak at like the Vitiligo conventions and different
yes.
things of inspiration. And it really has become a ministry. And so if you want to help build bridges in our country and you want to help build bridges in our world, this is a project that you can support that really says, hey, you know what? Let's put everything to the side. Let's celebrate our uniqueness. Let's look within to connect with people at a deeper level. Let's love one another.
Absolutely.
Appreciate one another and celebrate one another. So make sure you support, and we appreciate you in advance.